Hey, it's Nathan, and today I wanted to go through a particular modification of a famous mathematical thought experiment. In particular, there are a slew of creators that have taken the time to go through and explain the Hilbert's Hotel thought experiment. And so the premise there is that you've got this hotel with infinitely many rooms that you can label with the natural numbers, and then seemingly larger and larger sets of guests arrive to that hotel, and you can just move around people as you see fit in order to fit everyone into the hotel, that is, up until a certain point. Now, this thought experiment is used to communicate the intuition behind different sizes of infinity, and in particular, the mathematical concept of cardinality. And that thought experiment can be mathematized fairly quickly. So we go ahead and label rooms with natural numbers, and the method that we use to move guests around is that of a bijection, at least in the case when the sets of guests are infinite, and that's the case that we care about here. That is, everyone is handed one and exactly one room number to stay in. Now, if you have seen or heard of any of those other explanations, then you know that Hilbert likes to move around guests from room to room in order to accommodate any new guests that may arrive, even if the set of new guests that arrive is infinite. And this movement occurs independent of how many different guests Hilbert would have to disrupt in the movement process. Take, for example, just some practical person who is fed up with their stay at Hilbert's Hotel because they weren't able to get any sleep. People kept coming up, and so they had to keep moving rooms throughout the night. This practical person decides to open their own infinite hotel with the one rule that once a room is assigned to you, you stay in that room. You might then think that the practical person has made a fatal flaw. They've sucked all of the cool stuff out of Hilbert's Hotel thought experiment by forcing people to stay in the room that they're in. Well, I guess letting is probably the correct verb there because Hilbert just moves people around all the time, right? Anyway, so the practical person is letting people stay in their rooms for their entire stay while Hilbert moves people around. And so you might think that the practical man has eliminated the fun of Hilbert's hotel and too won't be able to fit everyone. Now, the way to adjust this adjustment of the thought experiment to accommodate for this is to say that the practical hotel runs off of reservations. So as long as the person running the practical hotel knows ahead of time of who is coming, they will be able to order things in such a way that they will be able to fit the same amount of guests as Hilbert's hotel does. However, once the practical hotel is full and there's, let's say, some random guest appears and they don't have a reservation, then that guest will be turned away. As you would expect, the practical hotel is marked as full more often than Hilbert's hotel. However, despite this seemingly constant availability, over time, Hilbert's hotel ends up going out of business. People realize that instead of going to Hilbert's hotel for a night full of changing rooms, they can instead make a reservation at the practical hotel and stay and have a night's rest. So, having run Hilbert's Hotel out of business, the practical person decides, hey, I'm gonna go ahead and acquire Hilbert's Infinite Hotel because my hotel seems to fill up sometimes because I make reservations and fill up the hotel and I can't always accommodate everyone. So now the practical person has an additional place to accommodate guests that arrive after their practical hotel is filled. So, the practical hotel will still run on reservations, but then there's this second hotel that can accommodate, let's say, one infinite set of guests that shows up without reservations. As the number of sets of guests that arrive to the practical hotel without reservations begins to increase, our practical person realizes that they need to build more and more infinite hotels to accommodate the demand for a night's rest within this world where infinite hotels and infinite sets of people exist. And so, this one practical requirement of letting people sleep through the night has a seemingly impractical consequence of that there need to be more and more infinite hotels in order to accommodate more and more people that show up at more and more times. So this introduction of reservations and the time at which guests arrive introduce a subtle difference between Hilbert's hotel and the practical person's hotel. Letting each tenant stay in the room allotted to them introduces a notion of order. And in fact, it upgrades the notion of bijections that were used for Hilbert's hotel and filling Hilbert's hotel to the idea of order-preserving maps that are not necessarily bijective. And the thing that's really interesting here is that it gives you sort of like the other math of infinity, whereas a lot of times we think about size of things and size of sets, and bijections are the right mathematical way to do that. Bijections don't comment at all about lengths of things, right? So the difference here is that while Hilbert's hotel was commenting on size, in some way the practical hotel is commenting on the length of things. So that all being said, this idea of going from size to length actually gives us a place to start talking about well orderings and ordinals in a mostly rigorous setting. So to give more details, at this point feels like I've spent too much time just introducing the thought experiment. So I'm going to save that for next time, and I'll introduce well orderings and ordinals and do all of that stuff and analogize it to the thought experiment accordingly and talk about it next time. I'm not going to go like dive straight into set theory, but I'm going to define what a well ordering is. I'm going to define what an ordinal is. I'm going to talk about some properties of those things. That's essentially all I wanted to go through today. Just easing back into things, making sure that I bite off just enough that I can handle, right? Just a little bit of a thought experiment to maybe introduce you to a different way of thinking about infinite things so that I can talk about ordinals and well orderings next time. So, yeah. Anyways, this video was finally a chalk video. Next one will also be a chalk video. So if you enjoy these mathy chalk things, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more of the math stuff I do on the internet. I also talk about how PhD stuff is going, which is probably somewhere up there at some point throughout the video. So yeah, as always, I am Nathan. This one was chalk, and I will see you next time.